One thing to point out, please don't go outside and eat dirt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or do, I'm not your mother. Ahoy friends, today on Chemists in the Kitchen, something to tickle your pickle. We are going to be doing quick fermentations in case you find yourself in a pickle, and long fermentations in case you have the time to relax in a salty bath. My name is Sudeep Agarwala. I'm a synthetic biologist at Ginkgo Bioworks.
I am Julie Pollack, and I am an associate professor at the University of Richmond.
My name is Kim Jacoby Morris. I'm a STEM program coordinator at the Air Force Office of Scientific Research.
So in terms of fermentation, what we rely on is actually bacteria that will break down carbohydrates and generate lactic acid. That lactic acid then decreases the pH in whatever it is that you're pickling in the solution that you're in, and it allows for the pickling process to occur. I'm going to be comparing traditional cucumber pickles in terms of fermentation process to the quick pickle.
So I'm really excited to share my kimchi recipe today. I was adopted by two Italian parents in New Jersey, so I know a lot of Italian and Portuguese recipes. But as I grew up, I really wanted to get closer to my Korean culture. So I'm excited to share how to make kimchi with a bunch of different vegetables. So napa cabbage, Korean radishes, leeks, all sorts of good stuff.
I have carrots. You know, we do these brine ferments in these special caps to let out gas. But you know, for hundreds of years, people have been doing the same thing with an oil layer on top. So I thought it'd be fun to introduce that.
Yeah, I think that's really neat. So you put oil goes on top of the brine in order to be able to hold it in.
I know people, you may have heard of this term, the microbiome, and people tend to think about that on the inside of their bodies, all over you and your skin as well, in addition to this. And I've not peeled to this carrot because, as you see all this fuzz and it's been growing in the dirt, and there's a bunch of different fungi and yeasts and a ton of bacteria. And the type of bacteria and the type of fungus and yeast are going to vary from the different soils that they grow in. But the seed coating often, frequently has an entire microbiome, an entire host of bacteria and fungi that live on its surface that actually help the seed grow and develop into a full vegetable.
And this is actually, I think your point is one of the things that, you know, when you're actually going to pick vegetables to pickle or to ferment, actually picking vegetables from a farmer's market or things that haven't been processed and are not sitting in a grocery store are actually better because of exactly what Sudeep has said, and that they have the bacteria still on them.
Please always, always, always do wash your vegetables before you eat them. And I don't wash my vegetables. I didn't use soap, but this is the magic of what we're about to be doing with the brine, right? Because the brine is going to kill off the things that we don't want. It's going to make space for the good bacteria that we want to continue to grow.
So in terms of my fermentation, which has been going now for 7 days, it's looking a little cloudier than I was expecting it to look, but it actually still smells very much like pickles.
So I cut mine into small bite-sized pieces and then throw in a bunch of other chopped vegetables. So it all follows the exact same process that you were talking about. There are a lot of scientific papers about kimchi and the food science and different health benefits. I thought that was fascinating. And then if you track the acidity as it's dropping, so your lactic acid bacteria are producing, you can actually watch colonies sort of die off over a 2, 4, 6 day period. So you're losing the listeria, the E. coli, salmonella, the things we sort of worry about with raw vegetables.
I put some bay leaves on top to sort of keep the carrots underneath. And there's shallots I put in, some coriander seeds. The important thing is to keep everything submerged underwater so that it creates an anaerobic environment. You know, for the first couple of days, there's gonna be a lot of gas that's coming off of there. And that's why, I don't know if you can see, there's this glass plate that's on top that's keeping everything submerged underwater. So you wanna kill off the fungi and the things which need oxygen to survive. And you wanna select for the lactic-fermenting bacteria that are getting their energy sources from the carbohydrates that are on your food. Now, the Indian achar is sort of a traditional recipe where you do very much the same thing. You have your vegetables, cut them up, you put them in the spice paste, and then you pour oil on top of it. And that oil plays the same role as this cap does. So this cap basically lets air out, but doesn't let air in. The oil is floating on top, and it lets all the bubbles and all the gases come out, but it doesn't let other gases come in as easily.
I have a weight that's holding down the cucumbers into it. This is actually releasing, this is a release for the air so that other air can't come into it. You want something that's gonna allow you to be able to submerge it completely in the brine that you're using. What, should we try? Should we try our pickles? Our fermented one? I'm actually really excited. This is my first time ever making it, so.
So I don't know if the audio picked it up, but when I opened my airtight container, it's sort of like, it was a little baby burp.
Yeah, same here.
One of the things I can really notice is, so I still have rum raw cucumber, obviously, and this is what my pickle looks like now. So let's just, clearly different color.
Beautiful.
I'm
gonna use the carrots. I have to say, like, the carrots maintain their color quite well. I think
I left my cucumbers whole associated with it. Oh my god, that's really good!
Yay!
And I don't know if you can hear me chewing or not, but it actually still has a bit of a crunch to it.
May have overdone it with the chili flakes.
How's your kimchi, Kim?
I really like it. It didn't come out that spicy this time, but it's really tangy. Right, because I'm gonna use this smaller container. I will probably put it back and use it for a soup or something later on. Definitely following the trend that you all were seeing with the coloration differences.
I think I checked this earlier in the week, but this is the achar, so you can see the oil sort of dripping off of it. Really, it's definitely, the smell is incredible. It's really changed since I started it on Saturday night. It's really...
Oh, I can hear the crunch with that one.
I really taste the sour notes.
Well, should we all start our quick pickle process and come back to talk about that afterwards?
Yeah, that sounds good.
So I'm quick pickling cucumbers, but in a very different way, I think, that Julie is. I'm going to be following a Korean recipe, and I slice them pretty thin, and they've been dehydrating or sitting in salt for quite a bit now.
Yeah, for mine, I'm doing equal parts water and vinegar and bringing that to the boil. I have black mustard, black pepper. you can't take me away from the red chili peppers, no matter how much I'm gonna live to regret it. And I actually thought, I've done this in the past with a little success, but I have some black tea that I'm gonna put in there as well, just for a different fragrance.
So I am using the same spices, and actually my pickle is done. So
yours is done, awesome.
All I do is a tablespoon of rice vinegar, a teaspoon of sesame oil, some garlic, and then for the spices, again, that Korean red pepper, chili flake, a little bit of sugar, salt, and sesame seeds.
So I also heated up my my vinegar. Mine is just straight vinegar, although I know I've seen a lot of recipes that use half vinegar, half water, like Sudeep is doing. And then I put in my bowl my seasoning. So again, I use my same seasonings that I did for the fermentation, which was a little bit of cumin seed, thyme leaves, celery seed, caraway seeds, a bay leaf, and a bit of dill as well. So I just poured it over the top of my really thinly sliced cucumbers.
So I am gonna use a food processor quickly, shifting gears to finish my second batch of kimchi. I have garlic, an onion, and a couple thumbs worth of ginger. Very scientific measurement there.
When we talk about these pickles, we think about the bacteria that are living on the outside of it. But what we forget is that the vinegar that we're using comes from bacteria as well.
Yep.
So oftentimes you'll have these vats of liquid where sugar is being converted into vinegar. That's the difference between a long pickle and a quick pickle. On the long pickle, you're letting the bacteria do the work of making the vinegar in the jar. And for a quick pot pickle, you have vinegar that you have from elsewhere.
The fish sauce scent is strong. So.
Well, but that's going to mellow as it ferments, right? Or it's going to change. It's not going to mellow, but it's going to change as it ferments.
I personally don't think that fermented kimchi smells like fishy. I think it has its own special scent.
So this is my raw cucumber. This is my quick pickle.
which is definitely more yellow. And then this is my, lastly, this is my fermented pickle.
I love it. Similar coloring to the kimchi from those red pepper flakes. You can see just like chunks of the seasoning on each vegetable. And so I think, Julie, it's somewhere in between your raw and your quick pickle in terms of the center.
In terms of carrots, this is a fresh carrot that I just, mm-hmm. just put together. You know, it's a little bit of bend. And this is the one that's been sitting on my counter for a week in a brine. So that's really, you know, still crunchy. A lot of the cellulose still intact. These are definitely, the color change, you know, those carotenoids, they take a lot to break down. There's different animals. Like, I can control the flavor that's going on in the quick pickle a lot better. With the longer fermentation, it's just a different thing because you don't know how those flavors are gonna evolve, right? Because there's different things acting on it.
So in terms of the taste of my quick pickles, I would say the dominant flavor really was the vinegar, the acetic acid that's there. But the fermented pickle, the one that had been with the flavors for longer, really pulled up more of the nuanced flavors.
Well, I always have fun getting together and making new things and talking about science with this crew.
Yeah, I think this was a really cool experiment, sort of comparing the quick pickle to the fermentation process and really getting to see the differences and really sort of determining, you know, you can make pickles depending on the amount of time that you have to be able to put into it. So you can do what Sudeep does, which is sort of make pickles whenever you want with whatever type of vegetable that you want when things are starting to look down, or you can just make a quick pickle to throw on top of a sandwich or a burger or something like that when you need it. And really you're just relying on that acidity, wherever you're getting that source of acidity from. And it's really just chemistry that you're doing in your kitchen to get that tangy, crunchy flavor for the pickle that you're looking for.
So it's been great hanging out and pickling with our briny buds. Until next time.
We did it!
I think maybe Kim should also sign off from the fermentation friends or the pickle pails or whatever.